It is always a memorable time for all of us. In front of us, as we will continue.
Some of you who have access to TV would have watched the budget debate last week in Parliament. And during the debate, during the break session, I mentioned to the Honourable Prime Minister, Honourable Warangi Bainimarama, that I'll have to visit the school soon, maybe later this year, and probably after August, because the school needs about an engine. And in the budget, we've got allocation for about an engine. So that budget kicks in from 1st of August. So I said to him, that Honorable Prime Minister, I'll visit the place after 1st August, because our new budget kicks in after 1st August. Honorable Prime Minister said to me, Doc, no, you don't wait for that new budget. You find money and go now. And he said to me, I don't want the children to wait. Honorable Prime Minister said to me, Doc, when you go, you also see if you can get take some stationery, bags, exercise books. And this is what we have here. But ladies and gentlemen, members of the Nunua, my presence here today is about what our Prime Minister stands for, the ideology that he stands for. And I want to take some time out to talk about what is that ideology that he stands for, what is it about, how different it is from the ideology of past Prime Ministers. And that's what I'm going to talk about now. That ideology is termed as one people, one nation, one destiny. So let me now explain to you what that ideology means to you as villagers, to these children, to education. Ladies and gentlemen, we in the Ministry of Education have 211,000 students with us. If we assume that there are two children from a household, that implies that we are dealing with 105,000 dreams, the dreams of 105,000 households. Dreams of all the parents sitting out there, dreams of all these children. And the ideology of our Prime Minister implies that every person's dream, no matter how old they are, where they originate from, matters to our Prime Minister. Our Prime Minister wants to ensure that every household's dreams are realized, every children's dreams are realized, no matter where they originate from, whether they come from VUTIA or Yasawas or Undi Point or the squatter settlements. He wants to ensure that every child's dreams comes true. Every parent who holds a dream about ensuring that the child gets an education and have a better living comes true. Ladies and gentlemen, it is this ideology that requires us, members of this government, members of the cabinet, to go and reach out to every family, no matter where they originate from, where they are. This government is not about governing based on armchair office governance policy. This government is about going to the people, looking at them, seeing how they're doing, what are the needs, and delivering to them. This government is about cutting across barriers of religion, ethnicity, gender, class and caste system and treating everyone equally. This government is about ensuring that when you have good business in town, good business in Suva City, Latoka, in urban areas, this government is about ensuring that the benefits of that good economy, good business, also comes down and trickle down to ordinary Fijians in the villages in the maritime division. This government is about ensuring that everyone participates in all aspects of life led by the government, because without everyone participating, the benefits of the growing economy will not trickle down to ordinary Fijians. Never before in the history of this country we have seen ordinary Fijians in the squatter settlements, in the interior, deep interior, in the maritime division, participating in government activities like this. On Monday and Tuesday, our Prime Minister will open two new campuses of the Technical College of Fiji in Singatoka and Rotoka. We have got 12 campuses of the Technical College of Fiji. One is right closer to you in Nasori. This government believes in taking education closer to the people, closer to your doorstep. We don't want distance to become an obstacle for your children to get education. This government believes that the long-term prosperity and stability in this country requires us to develop an educated and knowledge-based society. That's why this government is investing massive amounts of funds in education. In the new budget that is coming up, the largest amount of money is allocated to the education sector, over $700 million. We want to assure you that you don't have to worry about who will pay their fees when they go to primary school, who will pay their fees when they go to secondary school, who will pay their fees when they go to university or technical college. Government will pay their fees. Today I will talk to the principal of the other high school here and of course the head teacher of the other primary school to ensure that their school is ready, the infrastructure is up to date, to ensure that these children here and all the other children from this area get quality education in high school when they finish the primary school. After September parliament session, me, myself and our team will go and visit other areas in Fiji, Loma Viti group, interior and the Vanualevu, to ensure that every area, every children are getting the kinds of resources that require for them to have quality education. So that in another few years time, no school in this country should have any lesser quality of infrastructure as we have in urban areas. So members of the Vanua, ladies and gentlemen, I want to assure you on behalf of our Prime Minister and the Cabinet, government, that never ever you think that given that you are isolated here in one corner, we have forgotten you. No, no, no. In fact, all those people outside Suva or urban areas are more on our mind every point in time than actually the people in the urban area. We always are thinking about you. We will do what is needed to ensure that you also have better life than, like those people in the urban areas. Finally, I want to thank all of you who have come here to support the children's education. You have come here not for yourself, for the children of this village. I want to thank you very much for taking time out today. In particular, I want to thank the mothers out there who have, you know, probably woken up very early in the morning and started work. They'll be here, probably the last person to leave to clean up. Thank you very much. And on behalf of our government, I want to assure you again that we will look after all of you here and in Fiji. Thank you, Vinaka.
Nabonua,